report. After this ceremony, at the end of this ceremony, we will officially launch the Virtual University of Uganda Alumni Association.
You are the first fruits, and that is a great joy to us. You know, this is harvest time, and as chairman of council, it brings almost tears to my eyes.
And by the powers vested in me, I award the postgraduate diploma in international development of Virtual University of Uganda to the candidate whose name has been read.
I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome our esteemed guests, our VIP guests, Vice Chancellors, Deputy Vice Chancellors, family, friends. You're all most welcome to the first graduation of Virtual University Uganda. We'll be starting shortly. At the moment, we're only waiting for the guest of honor who is on his way. We'll start with the Chancellor's procession and the anthem. My name is Fiona, and I'll be taking you through as the MC for today. Thank you. Have a word of prayer led by Professor Deirdre Carabine.
Lord, our Creator, we thank you for this day which marks the lives of so many. We thank you for all those who made this day possible. We thank you for being a God of goodness, mercy, and understanding. Bless all of us here present, and may our lives be beacons of light for many. Bless us all for what we are and what we will be after today. We thank you for being a God of goodness, mercy, and understanding. Amen.
You may now take your seats. The Chancellor, Lady Justice Flavia Senoga, the Vice Chancellor, Professor Michelle Lejeune, Chairman of Council, Professor Patrick Mangeni, I welcome you all to the first graduation of Virtual University Uganda, the first fully online university in the region. I'll now take this opportunity to invite the Vice Chancellor to constitute the assembly into the first congregation of Virtual University of Uganda.
By the powers invested in me, I constitute this assembly into the first congregation of the Virtual University of Uganda.
May I now take this opportunity to invite our Vice Chancellor, Professor Michelle Lejeune, to address the congregation.
The Chancellor, Lady Justice Flavia Senoga Engling, members of the Board of Trustees, the Chairman of the University Council, Professor Patrick Mangeni, invited guests here present, staff of VUU, graduates and family, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure to welcome to VUU all of you. And I want to stress it right from the start, this is a virtual university, so many people are physically not present, but are present in mind and heart. You see very few graduates sitting there, but there are many more outside our country, in Sudan, Somalia, etc., who just couldn't make it for a few hours to fly into Uganda. But all of them are in our hearts, and this is very important. Thanks so much to all of you for having accepted our invitation. The 18th of July 2015 will remain in my memory as a memorable day where a project dear to our heart has seen it bear its first fruits. Really, this is a momentous moment we are living today. Indeed, in 2011, on the 26th of September, the National Council for Higher Education granted the young institution its provisional license and granted it also to a not-for-profit organization with the objective of offering postgraduate education exclusively online. And I want here to mention one person who was instrumental in this, Ambassador Achato, an old friend, who at that time was at the National Council, pushed also to get this done. Thank you, Yeko. It was a leap of faith, both of the National Council of Higher Education and of ourselves. The first students joined the university in 2012 and were offered the possibility to choose between public health and international development. There were 24 who enrolled at the university. For all, staff and students alike, we were entering into a completely new adventure and were not sure of its success. 3 years down the road, we are reaping the first fruits by witnessing the first graduation. For all of us, staff and students alike, it has been a steep learning curve, and we are proud that we kept the course we had designed and can now proudly say that we have 4 full programs on offer, namely a PGD / Masters International Development, Public Health, Business Administration, and ICT for Development. A specialization in oil and gas is offered from this year onwards with the Executive MBA. To reach this stage, we had to ensure that our students would receive the best possible materials, and our teaching platform, Moodle, is certainly a most user-friendly one, where students and staff can interact constantly. A library of some 50 million titles has been put in place, and staff and students, as well as the general public, can access it freely 24/7. This resource is unique, and no one can claim any longer not to have at his or her disposal the best possible materials. To ensure that quality is upheld in the materials offered, the various courses are reviewed after each academic year, so as to ensure that the latest information is embedded in the materials. Students are thus assured to be at the forefront of their subject and will always have the best available sources at their disposal. VUU does not want to work in isolation, and to share its knowledge with other institutions, VUU works hand in hand with the Research Education Network in Uganda, RENU, to constantly improve the techniques used and reach an ever-growing audience. VUU is in the process of setting up with RENU a network of willing universities in Uganda, which will share their materials and academics so as to bring the best possible to students of various institutions. Costs will thus be reduced and quality highly enhanced. This project will eventually, we hope, reach outside frontiers of our country and give to Uganda the aura of quality higher education. Agreements with other institutions will certainly be signed, and already Mbarara University of Science and Technology has signed an MOU with VUU. So did our University Council under the able leadership of Professor Patrick Mangeni, who advised us wisely and professionally all through these years. And all the members of Council, of whom I see here, Ms. Kadaga, Muindua Kadaga, the Director of the National Library of Uganda. Thank you very much for all what you have done. Madam Chancellor, ladies and gentlemen, a last word to our graduates. You are pioneers and have had the courage to join us in this adventure. Thank you, and my most sincere congratulations on your achievement. Your families, employers, and many others have supported you. I hope that VUU did not disappoint you. Go into the world and be our ambassadors. We need your support. After this ceremony, at the end of this ceremony, we will officially launch the Virtual University of Uganda Alumni Association, of which you will become the pioneer members. Thank you, and my most sincere congratulations. Madam Chancellor, ladies and gentlemen, let me conclude by once again thanking you all for what you did to help us and for simply being here today. We pledge that we will continue to offer the best we can so as to make VUU a first-class rated institution for the good and growth of our people and our nation. I thank you.
Our Chancellor, Lady Justice Flavia Senoga Anglin, Chairman, the Board of Trustees, all our guests, but more particularly our graduates. I want first of all to thank the Lord for the joy of this moment. You've heard from the report of our Vice Chancellor just what an amazing miracle this has been, at least for us from the perspective of the Council of the University. Over the last 4 or 5 years, we've seen a work grow from what looked like very improbable beginnings to something that we now can celebrate in a very special way today. We were told by friends that the name Vacho was something that would ensure we were dead at the beginning, dead in the waters. But we are delighted to be celebrating this first graduation. And I regard myself as part of the... Can you hear me now? As part of the kitchen staff. And so I'll give you a perspective, not so much from what Professor Michel Lejeune has mentioned. He is at the heart of operations and making sure things really happen. But for us in the background, there are things that we can be truly thankful for. First, I want to thank the Board of Trustees for entrusting me and my colleagues the work of being the people who look after their interest in the running and development of this university. Gertrude has been mentioned. Are there another Professor Mgambizia colleagues? Can you just stand up so that we can see your faces? It's not a virtual council, it's a real council, this one. So they are here. I want to, their names are listed in the documents that you have. It's been my privilege to work with these men and women over the years. We are now in the second council. They have worked extremely hard to provide advice, to provide guidance, and to ensure that the immense forest of institutions that you need to navigate to get a work like this going can be done so successfully. The National Council has been a great help to us. The other universities in this country have been, and so we are delighted to be able to celebrate a partnership that is growing and clearly delivering. I want also to thank in a special way two members of that council, Michelle and Dee Lejeune. Dee was our first vice chancellor. Thank you, Dee, for making sure that this work got started. The deliver of the baby. Perhaps it is very appropriate that we had a female person to start this. And it was a joy working with you, Dee. She decided that there was other urgent matters in the kitchen, and so we are there ensuring. Now, Michelle and Dee, you've made immense sacrifices. We have come to this day because we are prepared to put not just your hearts and your careers into this. Everything that you are has been put into this work, and we know from the perspective of the of the council that perhaps sometimes you've gone even without meals, you've missed holidays in ensuring that this work is started. We thank you that because of what you are prepared to become, we have become what we are, and we want to thank you for that. Thank you very much indeed. We sometimes sat down and wondered where we'd go next, and we thank you that you always had answers that we are convincing members of council to ensure that we had the quality of staff. We depended on your expertise, the bringing in people like Kyle Spencer and other professors from all over the world. Your contacts have been great. Your service to this nation is really reaching its apex in the work that we see before us. You've been pioneers in every way. Dee was the founder, vice chancellor of the International Health Sciences University, and Michelle started the Uganda Matters University. And we could see that as council in the work that has been carried on in this place. our students at our open day a few weeks ago were able to testify to the experience, expertise that has been woven into what we now see as the Virtual University of Uganda taking shape before our eyes. Thank you very much for that. And as I said, my colleagues on the council, thank you for your commitment. Now, any pioneering work is always going to be a work of patience, of perseverance in many places, and especially in a country like this. There are issues with the connectivity. If you are going to offer a program like this, you must solve all sorts of logistical and infrastructure challenges. And I want to thank the Vice Chancellor and the team, Vicky, our University Secretary, and many staff who have worked hard to overcome some of these challenges and deliver a quality product. From the perspective of council, as people who sit in the kitchen and see the supplies coming in, we would sometimes be worried what would happen. But we thank you, those who have worked hard, our staff and the management, to ensure that we've come to this moment. And finally, I want to thank you, the graduates. Thank you for believing and buying into our dream. Thank you so much. As I told you, people used to say, Mangin, what are you talking about, a virtual university of Uganda? Well, couldn't you find a more exciting name? They say Uganda is not a great brand internationally. The name Uganda sort of falls like lead through the water, doesn't it? But you've made us shine. We had testimonies from all across the continent. People have come to Michelle and Dee and said, we want to buy this thing, lock, stock and barrel. And this is because of what you have been. Your testimonies, the fact that you are there, you've worked hard, and Vicky has encouraged you. We thank you for believing in this work. You are the first fruits, and that is a great joy to us. You know, this is harvest time, and as chairman of council, it brings almost tears to my eyes to see that real people, flesh and blood, word has become flesh in our midst. Real people have been behind, across in virtual space, being part of this experience. Lives have been transformed, but even more lives are going to be transformed. The platform that we've set up here for delivering higher education is one that we think is going to change the future of higher education, not just in Uganda, or in this region, but across the continent. Thank you for believing in that vision. We know that you are our best ambassadors. Wherever you go, people will look at you and say, you've been to virtual university? You say, yes. Where is it? You say, well, it is right there, next to you. You don't need to, it's like that, like Paul was writing in one of the epistles. Said, the word is right next to you. You don't need to send somebody to go and get it for you. You can log on and get it. So thank you for believing in it. We want, as members of council, to congratulate you heartily. You've made sure that we are here. Your fees keep the enterprise going. When we look at the bottom line, we say it is because you believed in us. Thank you for doing that. But also, our greatest joy is that your going out is going to be the most powerful message that can come out of this place now, to say that the virtual university is here, the virtual university is working, the virtual university is a competent place and pioneering platform that is going to transform lives, not just of you, but of the people that you are going to impact again. And so thank you, ladies and gentlemen, those who have come, parents, those who have supported you, for being part of this. No longer a dream, but the reality. And so it now gives me great pleasure to invite the Chancellor to address the congregation. I've been reminded, I think I've run out of time. Aren't you lucky that I'm not one of your teachers? I would have been going on for 10 hours enjoying all this. But thank you for being here. And Lady Justice Flavia Senoga Anglin, it is my pleasure now to invite you to come and address the congregation.
Members of the Board of Trustees here present, the Chairperson of the University Council, Professor Patrick Mangeni, invited guests, the Vice Chancellor and staff of the Virtual University of Uganda, ladies and gentlemen, it is a very significant moment we are living in today. Indeed, in 2011, I was installed as the Chancellor of the just born VUU University of Uganda. And today I'm standing here very proud of what has been achieved. The first graduation is a milestone in the life of the institution, and I'm sure that it will give a stronger impetus to the life of the VUU University of Uganda. My thanks today go first and foremost to the promoters of this university, Professors Carabine and Lejeune. Your vision is a light in the field of higher education. You have shown that it is possible and even necessary to move forward and bring higher education into the 21st century with force and dedication. My most sincere thanks to you for your commitment. I also thank the members of the Board of Trustees here present and the members of the University Governing Council for their hard work and commitment to shaping the growth of this young institution. E-learning has become, in our world of today, a buzzword, and we as Ugandans still have to embrace it fully. There are so many constraints in higher education, let alone finances and resources, that virtual teaching must be brought on board as a unique tool to bring high quality education to all those who wish it. May I kindly ask you to be advocates for e-learning in the country and to help institutions of higher learning to move forward and improve constantly on the quality of their staff and academic materials. What VUU University of Uganda has achieved until now is an example which I believe should be emulated. Dear graduates, completing university studies at the level you have reached is a very great achievement. When VUU University was set up, we did not know what the future would be. We did not even know if students would join us. You have been pioneers in this, and we hope that, strengthened by the new qualifications you have attained, you'll become real ambassadors for VUU University of Uganda. My sincere congratulations to you all, and thank you for joining VUU University of Uganda. Dear guests, ladies and gentlemen, allow me to conclude these few remarks by reiterating my thanks to the promoters of the VUU University of Uganda project. What they have done will be written in golden letters for posterity to know. May what has been started give other institutions the desire to move into a new world and to bring our country new light and strength. I thank you all for listening.
Thank you very much, Madam Chancellor, for those very kind and enthusiastic words. May I take now this opportunity to recognize the presence of some of our very important guests. Professor Maviri, VC from Uganda Matters University. Dr. Adnan Adifata, representing the Vice Chancellor of Islamic University Uganda. Ambassador Achato. Dr. Paul and Mrs. Alatis from Trias. Professor Akimanzi from Dodoma. Ms. Gertrude Kayaga Mulindwa, the Director for National Libraries. Mr. Tom Forrest, one of the members of Board of Trustees. Engineer Isaac Kasana, the CEO of Renu. Professor Akik Biaruhanga, the DVC of Kampala University. Dr. Edward Manipo. Mr. John Van Heck, the General Manager of Kasia Lodge. Ms. Anne Hadouch, the counsel from the Belgian Embassy.
Professor Patrick Mangeni, Chairman of Council, and Dr. Bikai Toha, Member of Staff. Professor Mugambe, Executive Director of the Vice Chancellor's Forum. We've also received messages of congratulations to VUU and especially to the students from Dr. Martin O'Reilly, KIU Dar es Salaam, Ms. Evelyn Grace Ayot, who wasn't able to be here with us, the Registrar of IHSU, International Health Sciences University, and Mr. Nalianya, the lawyer of VUU. So now we'll proceed to the moment we've all been waiting for. What has brought us here? I can see the graduate smiling. May I now call upon the program leaders and the director of programs to present the candidates of the award of certificates, diplomas, and degrees.
Thank you. Madam Chancellor, I present to you the following candidates for the award of the certificate in project management of Virtual University of Uganda. The following are the candidates for the award of a certificate in project management: Apalot Barbara, Yarwahanga Rwaheru, Iliab Kwirizira, Hussein Farah Odowa, Kwesiga Wahab, Okulu Job, Rukani Hedwin, Susan Kwesiga, and Tony Kazubi.
I award the certificate in project management of Virtual University of Uganda to those candidates whose names have been read.
Chancellor, I present to you the following candidate for the award of the Postgraduate Diploma in International Development of Virtual University of Uganda, Justin Mucheri.
He's graduating in his absence today.
Madam Chancellor, I present to you the following candidates for the award of a postgraduate diploma in public health of Virtual University of Uganda: Berna Mugisha, Obwana Peter Ekifi.
By the powers vested in me, I award the postgraduate diploma in public health of Virtual University of Uganda to those candidates whose names have been read. And by the powers vested in me, I award the postgraduate diploma in international development of Virtual University of Uganda to the candidate whose name has been read.
As you all very well know, any university in the world who wants to be better known has got an alumni association, meaning the past students form an association which in fact are the ambassadors of that same institution. And therefore, I have the great pleasure and honor to launch the Alumni Association of Virtual University of Uganda today, and to receive all graduates of today into the newly formed family of the alumni of VUU. Congratulations for joining us. And may I ask each new pioneer graduate, you here present, to fill in after this ceremony, to fill in the register of the association, which will be placed at the reception, and Vicky will take care of that. We just want your name, where you come from, and your email address, that's all, so that we can keep contact with you whenever necessary. Thank you very much. It's also my pleasure to announce that an outstanding student of this year has been awarded a certificate of excellence in the form of a voucher offered by Cassia Lodge for a meal for two. And Mr. Johan Van Ecke, the managing director, is sitting there, will reveal the name of the person who receives this award. Please, Mr. Van Ecke.
The voucher as an appreciation, I think, from the whole university for the best, maybe the best student in this unique promotion, the first graduation, is going, unfortunately, I must mention, the person can only bring one partner. I know it's not easy in Uganda, but it's only for the person and only one partner. And the winner is Mr. Emmanuel Maraca.
I'd like to also recognize the presence of Dr. Kasekende Francis from Makerere University.
By the powers invested in me, I dissolve the first congregation of Virtual University of Uganda.
Standing as the Chancellor exits with the procession.
Thank you.
take their applications, they are admitted to the university, then all the lectures are done online, relating with other universities and the lecturers that are part of this university. Everything has got a beginning, I would say, and this is the first of its kind in Uganda. So we hope that after this graduation, when they become our ambassadors out there and tell people about it and they find that it's a good thing, then we shall have more people joining it. As I said in my speech, at first when we set up the university, we were worried that people may not join it. And you can see from the numbers that have been here today that it has begun as a small thing. But as people get to know about it and find how convenient it is, then we hope that we shall get more people. I do believe that if you are going to sit somewhere, it is going to be much cheaper than when you have, for example, to travel every day to a certain place and have to incur traveling expenses and all. But if you are online, I believe it is much cheaper than a normal education.